this to a almost not until the movie starts.
There you go.
There you go.
This was such a cool idea.
Thanks.
Just wait till we start playing and then.
Well, that was such a good value. Where did my stuff go? Take a second to crimp.
Well, welcome to the Rand's Head Live, everybody. I'm Roger Klein. This is PH Naffa. Thank you, Annapolis Peacemakers, for coming out to the Sound of the Founders, our first one on the East Coast. This is designed so that we can celebrate our 20th year together and with you, the inception of Honky Tonk Union and our Declaration of Independence with the song and story and cerveza. So also feel free, this is an open forum. And if you got anything you want to request or ask, please feel free and we'll go from there. We'll start with the title track, actually not the title track, it's the first song on the record, Honky Tonk Union, which we put out in 1999. After our first band, the Refreshments broke up and we decided we didn't want the headache or the yoke that was accompanied by, or that was requisite with the music industry model. So we just stepped off the cliff and we're still falling with y'all. We're having a good time on that trip. So This is Beautiful Disaster.
Yeah. C harp, please?
Any questions on that song? That's just our Declaration of Independence. That's we're hitting the highway awesome. Again in the van like we are now. Bus broke down yesterday and we're
right.
in the van. Oh, yeah. So thanks for coming and supporting the extra little ancillary we have here to help take care of those five figure repairs. God damn it.
Yeah, I bought your DVD like a few weeks ago and your wife made mention about the King of the Hill.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. Did you have any idea you were gonna get that or was it just a lark?
It was a lark, actually. So the King of the Hill story, yeah. It deviates a little bit from Honky Tonk Youth story, but if you guys, it's all one big washy career. Are we cool like addressing that? You want to stay curious to just with Honky Tonk?
No, sorry.
It was when the Refreshments were on Mercury Records that essentially Fox put out a casting call to all the labels asking for a theme for a Mike Judge of, at the time, Beavis and Butthead fame. Yeah, that's his... He was going to do an animated series, and my manager said, you got to write something, at least try it and pitch it. And I didn't do it at all. So 2 or 3 weeks go by, and he asked me, did you do it? And I was like, no, I didn't do that. I don't know who these people are. The Hills, I didn't know them. He's like, you got a pencil test. And the pencil test, as I recall, PH, was just like, there was no sound, no voice, no characterization, no, nothing at all.
It was literally just like black and white pencil scribbles.
Yeah.
Here you go, 30 seconds, good luck, everybody. Anyway, so I was fucking around. I was screwing around in Chicago and I came up with that little riff. Welcome, you didn't miss much. I won't go long. Screwing around Chicago at PH's house on a day off on the tour and was playing that little riff and PH ran downstairs and went, hey, that thing's cool. What are you gonna do with that? And I said, I have no idea. So he just laid down the drum track and I was like, let's give that to Fox. Let's do that thing. It's super simple. We made it 30 seconds long with a small B section. So what we did was we showed it to the band, and then in, I believe it was St. Louis or was it Kansas City?
Kansas City.
At the end of one of the shows, after we had a really successful weekday show, I thanked the crowd and said, got one favor to ask. We're gonna hit record on this next song that you've never heard, but please just freak out after it's done. It was the best thing you've ever heard. We're gonna send it to Fox and maybe get a chance at being on TV. So we played the song, the crowd erupted, we sent in the tape, and then 2 weeks later I was in Philadelphia and I got a call from our manager, and he said, you got time to take a phone call? And I said, yeah, he goes, it's a conference call in LA, hold on. Puts me on, and then these other voices come through the line and say, this is Roger Klein, yeah, other Refreshments? Yeah, it's kind of, this is odd. He says, well, who the hell you think you are? And then this voice was like, this is Hollywood, boy. We don't get to do shit like that. You don't just get to, this is the entertainment capital of the world. We have a certain standard. You don't just send in a cassette tape with a crowd cheering and think you're going to land what's going to be an internationally famous, groundbreaking animated TV show by the likes of Mike Judge. And I was aghast. I didn't know what to say. What happened was we forgot to cut the leader when we sent the tape in. We forgot to cut me talking to the crowd, so they got all that. Anyway, I was aghast. I didn't know what to say. And through my silence, they broke in. They were like, hey, this is Mike Judge, Joe Boucher, great Greg Daniels. We love the song. Would you please come to Hollywood and record it? And that was, so yes, it was a lark. That's how that happened.
I just wonder about that. You still watch that show.
I still watch that show. Yes, man, the utility bill. Let's do,
Would you do Viva Love?
Viva Love in the other set, for sure.
Cool.
We'll stick to Honky Tonk Union material on this one. Pardon?
Go a little local.
Yeah, we'll do that one, too. You guys are here. You guys are, for sure, we'll play those. This will do the Honky Tonk Union title track, which is Honky Tonk Union, based on experiences I had at the confluence of State Route 82 and 83 in Sonora, Arizona, where nearby where the Klein Ranch resides. Everything from UFO abductions...
Yeah,
it's true. PH can attest to just plain good color. This became the title track for Honky Tonk Union.
Down.
Getting married in a honky tonk bar. Union from Honky Tonk Union, 1999. Any other questions? Cool. Yes, sir.
During Jack and Jose, you usually call. Someone usually brings you tequila. How often do people bring you something else? Like, I did it before at State. I brought you Irish whiskey at the State Theater.
And did I call you out on it? Did we get in a fight after that? Usually I can tell. Yes, usually during Jack vs. Jose, I do get a gift or two of whiskey, good or bad. And sometimes I'm ready, sometimes I'm not. Sometimes I should definitely not be having any more, but I usually take it anyway. I can tell the difference usually with my nose, and so I'll give the whiskey now to Jim Dalton, who will be on stage here in just a little while. But
well,
yeah.
I give you a note. I give you a note saying I was Irish.
Oh yeah, you know, I get caught up. I rarely.
Well, you might as well have a fight.
Or if I can, my eyes just aren't as what they used to be. So if you put it in giant print next time in a Sharpie, I might be able to.
Yeah, I was trying to find Irish moonshine for tonight, but I couldn't.
I'm so glad. Not that we won't be accepting it. You know, lots of fun. Next song is City Girls. City Girls is a tale of do something here. City Girls is a tale of it's a true story in a couple of ways. There's a couple in Sonora whom I just the community I said where the Klein Ranch is near. Nearby, there was a couple there when PH and I were writing Honky Tonk Union. They were named Mike and Maureen, young couple, probably late 20s, early 30s, like we were at the time. And Maureen was a fashion model from New York City, and Mike was a cowboy. And so when Mike landed Maureen, it was everybody in the community. It's all good.
It's good.
I think yeah. It's good, yeah. I'm just gonna pour some beer in it. The community was astonished at how above his pay grade she was. They were a sweetheart, everybody was rooting for him. But it appeared that it's a close community. When you live in a community of about 60 to 120, depending on the season, everybody knows everything, and everybody thinks they know more than they actually know. Anyway, everybody saw Mike and Maureen sort of drifting apart. We saw Mike falling apart as Maureen was packing her bags over the course of a few weeks. And they were close to us all, and we just saw it break up. So we saw Mike get taken off in the squad car with a bottle of, actually mason jar, right? It said mayonnaise jar on the recording, probably because he used to drink out of a mayonnaise jar, which is larger than the mason jar. That's the community I come from. Anyways, he was breaking up, and so Hollywood wasn't falling for him, and it looked like our track too. We were just having a big love breakup with Hollywood, with the industry. And so as you listen to this song, go forward and watch Mike and Maureen break up and watch Mike get his feet, or watch the protagonist, the author, the singer get his feet and come to the kind of senses where I'm gonna have to walk on my own this way. Understand that that's the realization that we came to with Honky Tonk Unity, but not without support, not without knowing that we needed the audience. And so I dedicate this song to you because we couldn't do it without you. And to Mike and Maureen, who also ended up getting back together, getting married, and they run the bait shop at Parker Canyon Lake now.
Aww.
Little fucking rubby kids, and they're awesome. Hollywood ain't calling for me, and it don't look like she's falling for me now. City girls and me ain't meant to be. From a mayonnaise jar now, moonlight is a squad car. for the lights and the money. She said it was the showbiz, honey. But now Hollywood ain't shouting for me. And it's time to black, she's smiling for me. Them city girls and me ain't meant to be. Off on the drums. Brave and resolute and crazy enough to follow me into the unknown, and so were you. Thanks so much. It's been 20 years since we wrote that record, Honky Tonk Union, and we just got inducted to the Arizona Music Hall of Fame on its 20th anniversary, too. Thanks. Can't wait for that. Forum? Any questions, comments, concerns? Nothing. Those are too easy.
We're going back to Asbury Park.
We are going back to Asbury Park sometime soon. Steve Billington, tour manager, Asbury Park is when?
Yes.
Playing the Saint.
Yes, of course.
Some tiny furnace.
That's where I saw you the first time, you were PH.
Cool, right on, we're going to get back there.
I can't wait, man.
Good deal, thanks. What's your name?
Mike.
See you there, Mike. Awesome, are you local from there?
Yeah,
around?
We drove down here for that show.
Probably, thank you.
Yeah, think about that.
We're stationed up in Secaucus right now, where our bus is getting fixed, so we drove up here too, and we got to get back down.
Wow.
I remember a guy saying he was trying to find the Saint. The reason he knew he was at the right place, you were standing on the street corner waiting to go in through the back door, so he's standing on the corner.
But there's no back door.
Right behind the stage.
Is there now?
Yeah.
At the time, there wasn't. Anyway, now there is. See you in the second Asbury Park. Longest song, I believe, on the record.
What? Getting the hook.
Oh, we're getting the hook? We're getting the hook because we're going to do some photos with everybody and make sure we shake everybody's hands, say thanks, and sign the posters. And then we got to get dinner on, and then we got to get the rest of the band together. So we've got a little bit of a schedule. So this is a great time for me to play the longest song on the record. It's a true story. Daisy stands up on the tiptoes. The clouds stumbled over themselves in the sky. Devil's prey, but they'll catch your eye. plays a sad, sweet song. Mute moonlit statue mine. She wants his Sound of the Founders and honoring us with your presence. That's P.H. Naffa on the drums. He's been co-founder of the Refreshments and the Peacemakers. Brave, daring, stupid cohort.